Okay, hello everyone. Ang topic natin ngayon is on social psychology. To be more specific, we will talk about the social psychology of helping. For those of you who are reading the textbook by Myers, this is chapter 12 of the book. So punta kayo sa chapter 12 and then you read the entire chapter on helping. This is the summarized version of that chapter. But before I talk about the specific details on helping, let me just read Matthew 24, 34 to 40, which is very connected to the social psychology of helping. Then the righteous will answer him, saying, Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? And when did we see you a stranger and welcome you, or naked and clothe you? And when did we see you sick or in prison and visit you? And the king will answer them, Truly I say to you, as you did it to one of the least of these my brothers, you did it to me. So this is the word of the Lord, which is very connected to helping. According to the APA, ito raw ang definition ng helping. A type of behavior in which one or more individuals act to improve the status or well-being of one or more others. So anything that you do na ang goal mo mag-improve yung kalagayan ng isang tao, mas gumanda, mas umunlad ang buhay ng isang tao, can be considered helping. In the Bible, one perfect illustration of this definition would be the Good Samaritan. So dito, in the story, merong isang tao na in need at merong dumaan na Samaritan. In connecting this to the definition of helping, may ginawa yung Samaritan to improve the welfare of the person who is needing help. Sobrang baba kasi ng welfare ng tao dito. Pinagnakawan siya, ginulpi siya, sugatan siya. So, may mga ginawa yung Samaritan to improve the well-being of that person who is in need. To be more specific, if you read that in the book of Luke, he went to him and bound up his wounds, pouring on oil and wine. Then he sat on his own animal and brought him to an inn and took care of him. And the next day he took out 2 denarii and gave them to the innkeeper, saying, Take care of him, and whatever more you spend, I will repay you and when I come back. So those yellow words are behaviors that increased the welfare of the person in need. So we can say that the Samaritan in this story, nagpakita siya ng helping behavior. Pasok na pasok sa definition ng APA on helping. The same thing in the book of Genesis. Actually, Genesis pa lang, meron ng helping na nangyari. And many people don't realize this. If you read the creation account, this is an account where God is already helping future human beings. Kasi dito wala pang tao, no? From day 1 to 5. If you notice from days 1 to 5, God is already increasing the welfare of human beings even before human beings were made. Because God is already preparing the things that will increase the welfare of life of humans. Mas magiging maganda ang buhay kasi ng tao kapag merong mga halaman, merong mga prutas, meron tayong kakainin, meron tayong light, so on and so forth. So God already helped humans from days 1 to 5 bago pa man sila ginawa in day 6. So this is in line with the definition of helping according to APA. Genesis pa lang, Genesis 1 pa lang, meron na kaagad form of helping. But I think the greatest help na dapat nating tandaan, no, in connection to the definition of helping is when God helped human beings to be saved. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believe in Him will not perish but have everlasting life. If you read this passage very clear, this passage tells us God wants our welfare or our well-being to increase. So He sent His Son to help us have a better spiritual well-being. For God did not send His Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through Him. Yan yung next passage after John 3:16. Is that clear? This is the greatest help that human beings can receive from God. So all of those things I've mentioned, kaya ako sinabi yon, is to show you how the definition of helping by APA is experienced in our everyday life. Ayan. So those are the different forms of help. Alright? Now, if you read the chapter by Myers in his textbook, he outlined the topic on helping into four. Why we help, when we will help, who will help, and how to increase helping. So, dadaanan natin ng mabilisan yan, isa-isa. Let's start with number one. What's the answer of social psychology? Why human beings help? There are three theories to answer that question. Number one, social exchange theory. And then we have social norms. And we have evolutionary psychology. So, let's talk about social exchange theory. Why do we help? According to this theory, we help so others will help us. Kaya raw tayo tumutulong because subconsciously, in the future, we are expecting help from those people we once helped. Halimbawa sa classroom, bakit ka namimigay ng yellow pad? Para in the future, pag ikaw naman yung walang dalang yellow pad or naubusan ka ng yellow pad, ikaw naman yung tutulungan. Exchange lang. I give you help and then in the future, if I need help, you give it back. Number two, social norms means we help because we are taught to help. Tinuruan tayo ng society natin na tumulong. Paulit-ulit yan from our parents. Lagi tayong sinasabihan na mabuti ang tumulong sa mga nangangailangan. So the reason why we help is because we want to avoid being criticized, being punished by the society, by our family, by not helping someone in need. So papahiramin ko si Totoy ng laruan. Kasi pag pinahiram ko siya ng laruan, hindi ako pagagalitan ng parents ko. Kasi pag pinahiram ko siya ng laruan, pupurihin ako ng parents ko. Kasi ginawa ko yung social norm. Number three, evolutionary psychology. We help so we can survive and reproduce. Remember, in evolution, those are the two major values in life. Survive and reproduce. So bakit ka tumutulong? Tumutulong ka to increase your chance of survival. For example, in wars. Right? Bakit mo kailangan tulungan yung mga kapwa mo sundalo para tumaas yung chance na magsusurvive kayo sa war? Kasi kapag nagkanya-kanya kayo sa gera, if you become selfish, what happens? Your team becomes weak. And when your team becomes weak, most likely, madededs kayo sa gera. So you have to be helping each other out to increase your chance of survival. And why would you want to survive the war? So that after the war, you can propagate. You can reproduce. You can spread your offspring to the next generation. Ganun mag-isip ang evolutionary psychology. It's all about survival and reproduction. So the reason why you help, to increase your chances of surviving, therefore being able to reproduce at mapakalat mo yung lahi mo sa next generation. Now there's another angle in evolutionary psychology that explains why we help, no? We help daw to attract potential mates. Sinasabi rin yun ng evolutionary psychology, no, na kapag ang tao mahilig tumulong, especially among males, no, it is a strong signal to women that guys who help others are able to provide for her. Therefore, a lot of women are attracted to guys who help. And that explains the phenomenon of the old man and the young girlfriend. Diba, very common yan. Bakit marami mga young ladies na in love sa mga old men like him? Because he is so powerful, he is so wealthy, he is able to help many people na attract yung mga younger women sa kanya kasi signal yon na dahil marami siyang tinutulungan, implication yan, kaya niyang i-provide yung mga needs ko. So I find this guy hot in that sense. That he is able to help a lot of people in need. Ganun mag-isip ang evolutionary psychology. Let me clarify, ha? Evolutionary psychology ang nag-isip nun. Hindi ko statement yan. Because again, honestly, many people find these statements very sexist. And in a way, it is. But it is evolutionary psychology way of thinking. Now, one thing you can notice going back to this slide. Ano ang common among numbers 1, 2, and 3? These different theories on helping tells us that helping is self-serving in a way. Got that? Yan yung sinasabi ng tatlong theory. Social exchange theory, bakit ka tumutulong? Para tulungan ka rin in the future. Social norms, bakit ka tumutulong? Para maiwasan mo yung punishment, para matanggap mo yung reward ng society. Evolutionary psychology, bakit ka tumutulong? Para mag-survive ka, para magkaroon ka ng potential mates, para makapag-reproduce ka at dumami yung lahi mo sa next generation. So that's what these three theories are implying, that helping basically is a self-serving behavior. We help to serve ourselves. So I want to offer another alternative theory when it comes to helping that is very different from the three. Ito yung biblical explanation of helping. We help because it is in our nature to help. It has something to do with human beings being created in the image of God. What does it mean to be created in the image of God? It means we spiritually inherited some characteristics that God has, and that includes His nature to help, to improve the well-being of His creatures. Dahil ginawa tayo sa kanyang image, namana natin sa kanya yan, we are designed to help. Remember my example a while ago? In the creation, pinakita na kaagad dyan yung nature ng Diyos to help. That's His nature. And we spiritually inherited that nature to help. That's why I can say, you know, given our human nature, being created in the image of God, we are designed to help and to be helped. Another biblical support para dyan would be in Genesis, this time chapter 2. The Lord God said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make him for him a suitable helper." Study the logic here. Why is it not good for a man to be alone? In connection to this passage, because he needs help. So we are not only designed to help, but we are also designed to receive help. Got that? We got our desire to help others, our tendency to help others from the nature of God who created us. So yung marami na naman nagtataas ang kilay dyan, sinasabi na naman na nagba-Bible study ako ngayon, we have scientific support that we are designed by God to be helped and help others. Like for example, in our brain, meron tayong specialized part called anterior insular cortex. According to neuroscientists, this part of the brain is the seat of empathy. And what is empathy? This is the foundational emotion that enable us, push us to help, to be concerned about the welfare and well-being of other people. So kapag wala kang anterior insular cortex, kung hindi nag-work yan, less likely you would like to help others. But the fact that we have this part of the brain that is motivating us to help others means it is human nature to help others. It is human nature to receive help from others. And why are we like that? Because we are designed by our Creator to be like that. Kasi characteristic din niya yun, the ability to help others. So we also spiritually and biologically inherited that from our Creator. Now, in connection to that, there is this study. What happens to us when we follow our design to help others? Dinisenyo pala tayo ng Diyos to help others. So what happens to us when we follow our design? This study answers that question. Good things happen when we help others. Because again, we are designed to help others. To be more specific, let me read to you an excerpt of the abstract. Both helping others and receiving help were significant predictors of, everybody read, mental health. Giving help was a more important predictor of better mental health than receiving help. Pareho naman nakakatulong, giving help and receiving help, but statistically speaking, mas maganda ang impact sa mental health if we give help more than receiving help. Kasi yun naman talaga ang mas characteristic ng Diyos, no? He gives help. So when we follow that design, that we also give help to others, good things happen to us psychologically. This is also in line in one of the studies mentioned in the Myers textbook. Basahin na lang, the areas of the United States where people report the most happiness also tend to be what? The places with high rates of kidney donation. Yung mga area sa US na masasaya ang mga tao, yun din pala yung mga area na marami mga tao ang tumutulong sa iba via kidney donation. So when I read this study or this article and I read this study from the Myers textbook, nakakaalala naman ako ng mga biblical passages that are so in line with these studies. Solomon once said in one of his proverbs, "A generous soul will prosper, and he who refreshes others will himself be refreshed." Sounds familiar? That's the study. That's what the study is showing. When you refresh others, you yourself becomes refreshed. You give your kidney to others, you end up being psychologically happier. Jesus said, "It is more blessed to give than to receive." Where did we see that? We saw that from this study. That when you help others, it's a stronger predictor than you are the one receiving help. Mas maganda na ikaw yung nagbibigay ng tulong kaysa ikaw ang tumatanggap ng tulong. So there is really a strong agreement between spirituality and science in those last slides. Now, application, what can we learn from all this? Helping is a way of helping ourselves have better mental health. So, ang pinaka-obvious na application dito, find someone to help today. Kung sa tingin mo mababa ang mental health mo, one way to improve it is maghanap ka ng taong matutulungan mo. Sino kaya ang nangangailangan ng pera? Sino kaya ang nangangailangan ng pagkain? Sino kaya ang nangangailangan ng attention, ng care, ng love that maybe you can give to that person? By doing that, by helping someone in need, malaki na kaagad yung itataas ng psychological well-being mo, and that is supported many times in scientific studies. That's why Jesus taught, "Give to the one who asks you and do not turn away from the one who wants to borrow from you." Why did Jesus commanded this? Kasi trip niya lang? Kasi nagpa-power trip siya? Gusto niya mangutos? No, because Jesus knows this is good for our mental health. Kaya si Jesus, ang galing talaga niyang psychologist. He already knew this even before all those studies that I have shown you. New Testament days pa lang, panahon pa lang ni Kristo, alam na niya that helping is good for the human soul. And why is that? Because the creator of psychology happens to be the creator of everything. So I'm not surprised why Jesus already knew this. Alright? Now let's move on to number 2. When will we help? When are the situations that people are more likely to help? Isa yan sa mga tanong na sikat in the field of helping. Okay, now, the main experiment or the main study where we will answer this question comes from the study by Darley and Latan, the very popular bystander effect studies. Okay, so if you are a psych major at nag-social psychology ka, dapat nabasa mo na yung article na to on bystander intervention. Okay, by Darley and Latan. Now, one thing I want you to know about this study is, this is actually a series of studies. Kasi usually, psych majors think na yung bystander experiment, isang experiment lang siya. No. Bystander experiment should be called bystander experiments. Because there are many studies repeated over and over again while they are varying certain variables in the experiment. Nagigets nyo? So yung series of studies na yan, marami silang mga minamanipulate na variables to learn more about human beings' tendency to help others. So ang classic setup nito, if you're gonna do this in the field, no, yung bystander experiment, this series of studies involve this scene. Merong nakahiga dyan, parte yan ng experiment, this is the confederate, while people around, the people around this confederate seeing the emergency situation, seeing someone in need, are the real participants. So tinitignan ng mga experimenters, how will the audience, how will the participants in this study react to the person who is in need? So what are the things that they learned from the series of bystander studies they have done? Number one, people are more likely to help when the burden is on them. Kaya nga dito na yung dito na papasok yung the number of bystanders present. According to the bystander effect, the more people are seeing someone in need, ironically, less likely, let me repeat, less likely help will come. Sa Tagalog, mas marami nakakakita ng isang taong may klarong pangangailangan, mas mababa ang chance na merong magre-respond. So in a way, mas maganda pa na konti lang yung nakakita ng isang tao na nangangailangan, mas marami pa ang magre-respond. And what explains that? Why is it that the more people see someone in need, less likely help will come? Nagkakaroon kasi ng diffusion of responsibility. Diba? From the term itself, diffusion, it means you pass to others. You move the responsibility to others to respond to that person who is in need. Ang ending, lahat kayong nakakakita doon sa tao, yun ang iniisip. Bakit ako tutulong? Siguro may iba nang tumawag ng tulong. Yun din yung iniisip ni Pedro. Siguro naman may iba na tumawag para tumulong. Yun din yung iniisip ni Judas. Siguro naman may iba nang tumawag ng tulong. Lahat sila yun ang iniisip. Ano ang ending? Nobody responded. So that explains why. Bystander effect happens. More people seeing the situation, less likely help will happen. Pero kapag i-cancel mo, going back here, i-cancel mo yung tatlo. Sabihin mo isa lang yung nakakita ng emergency situation, there will be no diffusion of responsibility kasi wala siyang papasahan ng responsibility. The burden is on the person to respond. So more likely, this person is gonna help that person in need kasi wala siyang papasahan ng responsibilidad eh. Diba? So yun yung ibig sabihin ng number one. When the burden is on the person to help, the presence of bystanders will decrease that burden. Therefore, that person will less likely to help. Number two, we are more likely to help when people think that the person who needs help really needs help. Ang mga tao, tutulungan ng isang taong nangangailangan na talagang kailangan nila ng tulong. Now, in the series of bystander experiments, ito yung isa sa mga variables na minanipulate nila. The person is in need is drunk versus the person in need is sick or had an accident. Ano ang result? Saan mas tumutulong ang mga tao? Doon sa situation where the person in need is sick or suffered an accident. Less likely help will be received when the person is drunk. Kasi iniisip ng mga tao, bakit namin tutulungan yung drunk na yan? Eh, kasalanan naman niya. Kasalanan naman niya kung bakit siya ganyan. So, although he is in need, hayaan natin siya, huwag natin siyang tulungan kasi kasalanan niya kung bakit nandyan siya sa ganyang situation. Diba? Pero yung sick kasi, yung accident kasi, hindi naman pinipili ng tao yan eh. Hindi niya ginusto na magkasakit. Hindi niya ginusto na maaksidente. Pero ang drunk, ginusto niya na malasing. Yun. Kaya ang mga tao, more likely to help someone who is sick, someone who is a victim of accident, more than someone who is drunk. And this fits the description of what happened in the Good Samaritan. Diba? Kaya niya tinulungan, kaya niya tinulungan yung tao doon sa story kasi biktima yung tao. Hindi naman niya ginusto na mabiktima ng mga robbers while he was walking. So the Samaritan responded to that person because he saw the situation that way. This person clearly needs to be helped. Hindi niya kasalanan kung bakit nandyan siya sa ganyang situation. Alright, so that's number two. When people think that the person really needs help. Number three, people are more likely to help when somebody responds to help. In social psychological terms, ang tawag pala dyan is pro-social modeling. So, in the original bystander experiment, wag muna yun. No? Ito pala muna. In one of the pages by Myers, in the textbook, there was this very interesting study. Los Angeles drivers were more likely to offer help to a female driver with a flat tire if a quarter mile earlier, they had witnessed someone helping another woman change a tire. Pero itong nandito, yung na-witness nila before, someone helping another woman change tire, ano lang yan? Accomplice. These are the confederates. So kapag yung mga drivers nakakita ng isang taong tumutulong sa naplatan ng kotse, most likely, tataas yung chance na tutulong din sila sa isang taong naplatan ng kotse when they see one. Diba? So when people, ang sinasabi lang dito, people are more likely to help when we see other people are also helping. Now, let's go back to the original bystander experiment. Where did we see this principle at work? diba, doon sa experiment, merong person in need and no one is responding. Question, when is the time that finally everybody responds to that person who needs help? When somebody takes one step to help, everybody, almost everybody will also respond to help. Ang kailangan lang talaga sa Tagalog, merong magsimula na tumulong doon sa taong nangangailangan. When that happens, finally may isang tumulong, may isang nag-respond. Halos tataas yung number of people who will also respond to that person who needs help. Anong tawag doon? Pro-social modeling. People are more likely to help when they see others also helping. Number four, people are more likely to help when there is no time pressure. So meron din palang factor yung time pressure whether or not people will help. In one very popular experiment, yung Princeton Seminary student study by Darley and Batson. So hindi na sila tan yung partner niya dito, si Batson na. No? So very quickly lang, in this study, meron mga seminary students, sinabihan sila that they need to go to another building to deliver a speech. Okay? Pero yung mga students involved in that study were divided into two groups. In the first group, sinabihan nila yung mga students who needs to go to the next part, to the other building, I mean, sinabihan nila that they still have time to go there and prepare for the speech. So yun yung in a few minutes condition. But on their way to the other building, they will encounter someone who is in need. Nandoon, nakabulagta doon sa entrance of that other building where they need to go to. So the experimenters wanted to know whether they will respond or not, no? So in the condition where they were told they still have time to go there to the building and prepare, more students help that person in need. So yung mga estudyante na alam nila na marami pa silang oras, most likely tinulungan yung taong nangangailangan. But for the second condition, these were the students who were told, you really need to hurry up. You really need to go to the other building, run, because you're running late to deliver this speech. For those students, almost none helped the person in need. Nag-gets nyo? So, ang conclusion dito, kaya rin pala tayo tumutulong or hindi tumutulong, may kinalaman din yan sa ating perceived availability of time. Number 5, we are more likely to help when the person is similar to us. This is very interesting. In social psychological terms, ang tawag dyan, in-group similarity. Mas tutulungan mo yung isang tao kapag na-sense mo na yung taong yon, kapareho mo ng category. Let's go back to the original bystander experiment. Isa sa mga variables that they manipulated is the dress of the person who is in need. So in one condition, yung taong nangangailangan, yung nakahiga sa street, naka-formal attire. So according to the data, sino yung mga tao na nagre-respond dito sa taong to? Those people who are also in formal attire. And vice versa, in another condition, they designed it this way. Yung taong nangangailangan is in casual wear. Question, who are the people who are more likely to respond to this person? Those people who are also in casual wear. We help people who we think we have the same category in. Kung tingin natin, pareho tayo ng category doon sa taong nangangailangan ng tulong, more likely tutulungan natin yan. Again, ang tawag doon is in-group similarity. In another very popular experiment in connection to in-group similarity, pinag-aralan nila yung fans ng football. Specifically, Manchester United and Liverpool. So, ang pinagtripan dito yung mga Manchester fans. And then the experimenter, ang design ng experiment niya, yung accomplice, yung confederate is dressed in a Liverpool uniform. Meron din silang accomplice na nakadress naman in Manchester uniform. Again, they were observing Manchester fans. So they would like to know kung merong bang epekto yung suot na jersey ng taong nangangailangan, whether it's Manchester or Liverpool jersey, in the rates of these fans, Manchester fans, helping or not. And this is what the data shows. Let me zoom in. Focus on this part. Manchester fans are more likely to help someone in need, especially when that person, the person in need, is wearing a Manchester jersey. Pero kapag yung suot ng taong nangangailangan is Liverpool, yung arch rival nila, may tutulong din naman pero sobrang konti. People are more likely to help who? People to whom they belong to a similar group, which is being a Manchester fan. Got that? Dito naman, nilagyan lang nila ng control variable, nilagyan nila ng plain white shirt. Pero, same. People are more likely to help people na kapareho nila ng category. Less likely to help people na iba sa kanila. Okay? So, that's what you mean by number 5. Kaya nga, balik tayo sa slide, no? Kaya nga, this is the reason why Christianity is counterintuitive when it comes to our tendency or when it comes to our pattern of helping. Diba? Ang Christianity kasi, hindi tinuturo na dapat bias ka sa mga tao na kapareho mo lang. Hindi mo dapat tinutulungan lang yung mga tao na kapareho mo. No in-group bias. There is no in-group bias in the doctrine of salvation. Hindi mo lang dapat share-sharean ng gospel, which is a form of helping in Christian perspective, no? Sharing the good news. Hindi mo lang share-sharean ng good news yung mga gusto mo, yung mga kapamilya mo. Hindi mo lang share-sharean ng good news yung mga ka-teammates mo. You need to share the gospel to who? Everyone. For I am not ashamed of the gospel according to St. Paul, for it is the power of God to salvation for who? Everyone who believes. There is no in-group bias in salvation. Diba? This violates this tendency of in-group bias when it comes to helping. Now, let's move on to number 3. Tapos na tayo sa why we help. Number 2, tapos na tayo sa when we will help. Now we enter who will help. Ano ba yung profile ng isang tao who is more likely to help people in need? Meron palang factor dyan ang ugali ng tao, personality factors. You remember the big 5, the ocean. Studies show na meron palang connection yung mga big 5 traits na yan kung sino ang most likely tutulong. Ano ang profile nila? Yung mga mahihilig tumulong. Number 1, mataas ang agreeableness. We are not surprised because these are the nice people. And one of the qualities of a being of being nice person is they help a lot. That's how they express their niceness. Sila yung nagpapautang, sila yung nagbibigay ng pagkain, sila yung madalas nagpapahiram, so on and so forth. People are more likely to help kapag mataas ang level of extroversion, and it makes sense because people who are extroverted love people, and one way to express your love for people is to help them when they are in need. And number 3, people are more likely to help kapag mataas ang level of neuroticism. Anong kinalaman ng neuroticism sa willingness mo to help? Because these people easily feel bad when they see someone struggling. And to get rid of that negative emotion, para matanggal yung guilt nila, para matanggal yung awa nila, doon sa tao na nagsasuffer, they are more likely to help. So parang negative reinforcement, no? Tutulungan nila yung taong nangangailangan para bumaba yung negative emotions nila. O kaya anong application dito, now that we know the personality profile of someone who is more likely to help, ito yung mga utangan ninyo. So kung nangangailangan kayo ng pera, gusto nyo nang magpapautang sa inyo, hanap kayo ng mga tao na ganyan ang profile. Mataas ang agreeableness, mataas ang extroversion, mataas ang neuroticism. Next, who is more likely to help? May kinalaman din pala ang gender. If I ask you, sino sa tingin nyo ang mas matulungin? Lalaki ba o babae? Anong sagot ng social psychology? Depende sa sitwasyon. Wala naman talagang gender yung mas tumutulong over the other. Kasi pareho naman tumutulong ang lalaki at ang babae. Again, we are created in the image of God. So males or females, we inherited that nature of God to help other people. Pero depende sa sitwasyon kung kailang tumutulong ang lalaki o ang babae. Like, for example, in studies, sabi nila, males are more likely to help in physically dangerous situations or situations that require high physical exertion. So kapag yung sitwasyon, yung kailangan tulong, ganyan ang nature, dangerous, kailangan mong iligtas yung tao from a dangerous situation, or yung sitwasyon kailangan ng malakas na effort to help a person, more likely males will respond. Halimbawa, merong naplatan sa daan, most likely lalaki ang magpapalit ng gulong. Lalaki ang tutulong na magpalit ng gulong. Kapag may sunog, magliligtas ng mga gamit, magliligtas ng mga tao, magliligtas ng mga aso, most likely, mga lalaki ang tutulong. Kapag may naaksidente sa daan, may sumemprang na motorsiklo, most likely, mga lalaki ang tutulong. Pero kapag ang situation is more on nurture ang kailangan to help someone who is struggling, babae ang tutulong. Some examples would be babysitting, mag-aalaga ng bata. Next would be tutoring, tutulungan mo intellectually yung isang tao to get a certain concept na pinag-aaralan niya, or counseling. Diba? Merong isang kaibigan, malungkot, gusto niya ng karamay, gusto niya ng makukwentuhan, most likely, ang mag-cater ng tulong na yan would be women. Kaya, sabi nga nila, no, in the field of counseling, mas marami talaga mga babae kumpara sa mga lalaki, because it fits that situation in counseling that females are more likely to respond. Kasi nurturing profession yan eh. So when it comes to situations that needs nurturing, most likely, babae ang tutulong. Who is more likely to help? May kinalaman din pala dyan ang religious factor. In general, religious people are more likely to help, and we are not surprised. Kasi kapag active ka sa religion, active ka sa church, you absorb certain values related to helping. Isa sa mga doktrina in the Christian spirituality, for example, is this one, nakalagay sa Hebrews, and do not neglect to do good and to share with others, for with such sacrifices, God is pleased. So punta ka ng punta sa simbahan, si pastor, preach ng preach niyan, so na-absorb mo yan, that makes you more likely to help someone in need. Diba? There's this experiment to support this by Voss et al. 2008. So in this experiment, dinala nila yung mga tao sa laboratory, and they were primed to see certain images. At yung mga images na to, yung isang grupo, ito yung slide, no? Yung isang grupo, they were primed. They were shown images in connection to spirit, divine, God, and the sacred. Okay, so ito yung mga images na pinakita sa kanila for the first group. For the second group naman, ang mga images na pinakita sa kanila has something to do with salary, money, fame, power, very materialistic words. Dito, very spiritual words. And then the dependent variable here, gusto nilang malaman if this priming will affect their tendency to help another person in need. And what was the result? Fast forward, those people who were primed with spiritual ideas, sila yung mas tumaas yung, sila yung mas maraming tinulungan kumpara sa mga tao who were primed by materialistic ideas. Oh. Kaya nung nabasa ko tong experiment na to, naalala ko yung isa pang biblical passage which is very much in line here, no? When the Bible says, "For the love of money is the root of all kinds of evils." Love for money is being materialistic. So ang implication dito, being materialistic will make a person less likely to help. Kaya pala root of evil. Root of all kinds of evil yung love for money. Take note ha, love for money. Hindi ko sinabing money is evil, but the love for money is evil. Why? Bakit siya tinawag na evil? Because it will make you calloused. It will make you less likely to respond to people who needs help. Kaya siya nagiging evil. Kasi ang tao nagiging materialistic. And do we have support for this? In connection to this experiment, in connection to this passage, meron. I highly recommend you read this article. I-zoom in natin para makita ninyo yung buong title. Ayan, i-download nyo sa Google yan, basahin ninyo. Does materialism predict racism? Materialism as a distinctive social attitude and a predictor of prejudice. To make the long story short, ano ang finding nila? Nakita nila that this model is true. Materialism makes people selfish. And that selfishness is translated to being prejudiced, practicing racism. So saan nagsimula lahat yan? Kasi masyadong mataas ang materialism mo. Which is again very in line with this experiment reported in the Myers textbook. Pag prenime mo kasi yung mga tao like this, pinapataas mo yung kanilang materialistic attitude, therefore, they are less likely to help. So the Bible was right all along that the love for money, being materialistic, is not good for us. It makes us evil. Evil in a way, we don't respond to people who clearly needs help. Oh my goodness, there is a lot of connection between psychology and God's Word. Because God's Word is also the one who created psychology. Anyway, number four, last one, how do you increase helping now? After everything we learned so far, paano tataas yung chance na kapag ikaw yung humingi ng tulong, tutulungan ka? The following are some applications. Number one, gawin mong personalize yung appeal. So when you are asking for help, dapat ikaw mismo, in person, ang hihingi ng tulong sa isa pang tao. By doing that, tataas yung chance na tutulungan ka. Huwag mong idaan sa internet, huwag mong idaan sa sulat, huwag mong idaan sa ads. Ikaw mismo ang makiusap sa isang tao. Natulungan ka, mas mataas yung chance na tutulungan ka. For example, in one study by Foss, new blood donors donate blood because why? Someone they know invited them. Bibihira lang yung gustong mag-donate ng blood kasi nakakita siya ng ads na pwede mag-donate ng blood. Kasi yung ads, hindi siya personalized. Kailangan may kakilala ka na siya mismo yung hihingi ng tulong sa'yo kung pwede ka ba mag-donate ng dugo. Another technique to increase helping is to decrease anonymity. This idea comes from a study by Solomon and Solomon, 1978. Right? Wait. Yan. So, ang ginawa ni Solomon and Solomon dito, ni-replicate nila yung bystander effect, but this time, merong twist. In their version of bystander effect, kinilala nila, inalam nila yung identity ng mga bystanders. They were personally identified. And then they ran the same experiment, and what did they find out? Halos walang nangyaring diffusion of responsibility. Almost everyone immediately helped someone in need. And the explanation is because the bystanders knew that they are identified by name. Mataas yung kanilang sense of personal responsibility kasi nga alam nila na kilala sila ng experimenter. Alam nila na na identified sila. Unlike in the original bystander experiment, hindi naman ginawa ito, merong anonymity. And being anonymous, in a way, makes you more confident not to respond. Diba? Eh ano ngayon kung hindi ako mag-respond? Hindi naman ako kilala ng mga tao. Pero kung alam mong kakilala ka ng mga tao, may mga tao nakakakilala sa'yo at nakita ka nila na hindi mo tinulungan yung taong in need, ayaw mo yun, mapapahiya ka. So you are more likely to respond if you know that you are identified as who you are by the people around you. So that's another way to increase helping. Number three is to induce guilt. Guilt is a very powerful emotion para ma-push mo yung tao na tumulong. Kaya karamihan ng mga appeal for help na lumalabas sa Facebook, sa social media, eh merong paawa effect. Diba? Yung nangangailangan ng tulong, talagang may picture siya doon. Tapos nakakaawa, nag-i-struggle siya. Why is that done? So that people who will see the picture, tataas yung kanilang sense of guilt, therefore, more likely to help. Diba? Kumbaga parang sinasabi mo, if you use this strategy, something bad will happen if you don't help. Kakayanin ba ng sikmura mo? Kakayanin ba ng puso mo na mamatay na lang siya? Wala ka man lang ginawa. You did not even lift a finger to help. Sana naman wag kang ganyan. Kaya please lang, tulungan mo naman itong taong to. Diba? So when you phrase that appeal that way, you are inducing guilt, which is more likely to increase helping. O, kaya yung mga namamalimos din sa kalsada, no, as you can see on the picture, meron silang mga sulat. At pag binasa mo yung mga sulat, ano ang common denominator? Talagang magigilty ka kapag hindi ka tumulong. Pangkain lang po, pang-uwi lang po, hirap na po ako. So when people read those messages, guilt will increase, therefore helping will increase. Number four, another way to increase helping is you ask for small help. This is based on a study done by Cialdini and Schroeder, 1976. Nakadiscover sila ng magic phrase in soliciting money para marami ang tumulong. And what is that phrase? Na kapag sinabi mo, most likely, marami magbibigay. In English, even a penny will help. Tagalogin mo, kahit barya lang po. It's a very powerful phrase. So kapag humihingi ka ng pera, dapat may karugtong ka na kahit barya lang po, kahit pangkain lang po. Ang social psychology explanation dito kasi, parang pinaparating mo, china-challenge mo yung taong hinihingan mo ng tulong na konting barya na nga lang hindi mo pa mabigay. Anong klaseng tao ka ba naman? Parang ganun. So subconsciously, that's the messaging. And so to prove to themselves that they are capable of helping in just small amounts, pag narinig na yung kahit barya lang po, magbibigay sila ng barya. Or, hindi barya ang ibibigay, mas malaki pa sa barya na hinihingi mo. Yun ang explanation ni Cialdini and Schroeder. Diba? To be more specific, kapag ginagamitan ng ganitong phrase, even a penny will help, or sa Tagalog, kahit barya lang po, yung solicitation ng money tumataas, mas marami ang nagbibigay, from 39 to 57%. So kapag hindi mo sinasabi yung kahit barya lang po, 39% ang nagbibigay. Pero pag sinabi mong kahit barya lang po, 57% ang nagbibigay. At karamihan sa mga nagbigay, hindi barya ang binigay. Mas malaki pa sa barya. Alright? So yan, ang technique dyan, ask for small help. And number 5, another way to increase the chance that people will help others is to socialize people to help. Remember, going back to my idea a while ago, materialism has suppressed our nature to help. Because of commercialism, because of materialism, yung disenyo ng Diyos sa atin that we are designed to help others, nawala. Kasi materialism teaches us to be selfish. It's useless. It's pointless to help others. Help yourself first. Yan ang sinasabi ng materialism. Kaya marami mga tao ngayon less likely to help. Pero ang good news, although our tendency to help has been suppressed, we can relearn. Everybody repeat that word. We can relearn our tendency, our design to help others. And one way to relearn this is for the society, for our environment to teach us to help again. And there are many ways how to do this. Letter A, modeling. Mahalaga yan. Na dapat, tayong mga tao, meron tayong mga nakikitang ibang tao, especially people we idolize, helping other people. Kaya maganda na sa showbiz yung mga artista, nagkakaroon sila ng mga charity, at ako, agree din ako, na dapat pinapublicize nila yan. Now, many people will raise their eyebrows. Eh, yung mga artista naman na yan, tumutulong lang yan for show. Tumutulong lang yan para dumami yung subscriber niya sa YouTube channel niya. Now, sabihin na natin, sige, ganun nga. Sabihin na natin, hindi sila sincere sa pagtulong. Talagang for show lang to. But in the level of social psychology, this is a good thing. Why? Because they are modeling the behavior of helping, which will increase helping behaviors of people. When people see their idols helping other people, these people are also more likely to help. So ang point ko lang dito, whether they are sincere or not, yung mga artista na tumutulong sa ibang mga tao, wag na nating problemahin yan. Because whether they are sincere or not, it is good socially. Because people will imitate these good behaviors by the artistas. Wag na nating problemahin kung sincere sila o hindi. Kasi sila lang naman ang nakakaalam yan. Wag na natin isipin yung mga bagay na hindi naman talaga natin malalaman at all. Alright? Another way to relearn our design to help is through education. Malaki ang role ng school in shaping people to desire helping others in need. Kaya marami mga schools ngayon, may mga curriculum sila to improve on our helping behaviors. Kaya may NSTP, kaya may CWTS. Kaya sa Lasal, ang emphasis, sino dapat ang target na nakaka-receive ng benefits ng scholarly outputs natin, the least, the last, and the lost. Kaya ako, I am really for these programs in school because it forces students to be placed in a situation where they will help people in need. Magpapakain ka ng mga batang gutom dyan. Tutulong ka gumawa ng bahay sa mga programs na yan para sa mga taong walang bahay. Magtutor ka ng mga estudyante who are the recipients of poor quality of education. Gusto ko yung mga programs na yan because again, by undergoing this program, Lasallians and students in general, they begin to relearn our design to help others. Yung iba nga, sobrang na-attach sa mga programs na yan that when they graduate, yan na yung gusto nilang gawin sa buong buhay nila to help people in need. So this is a good program. Keep it up. Dapat ituloy-tuloy yan. No? And last one, letter C, another way for us to relearn our design to help is none other than spirituality. We really need the church. We really need religious institutions to help people relearn how to help others. Kaya huwag rin tayo magagalit sa religion, no? Shout out dyan sa mga taong galit sa religion, hindi masama ang religion. Meron ding mga religion, meron din namang magandang contribution ang religion sa psyche natin. Specifically, religions help us rediscover our tendency to help. Like we have a study on this, the effects of religious orientation on spontaneous and non-spontaneous helping behaviors. To make the long story short, those people who are highly religious, those people who are always active in church, are more likely to help other people. Yan ang magandang contribution ng religious institution. It will enhance our spirituality, which will be translated to us helping people in need. So let me close this lecture by reading this passage, isa sa mga passages na tinuturo sa simbahan when it comes to helping. Diba? Isa sa mga tinuturo would be this one. One day, during Judgment Day, people will be placed on God's right hand. And if you know the Christian doctrine, in the Bible, whenever people are placed on the right side of God, they are blessed. They will be allowed to enter the kingdom of God. Bakit sila nilagay sa kanan? Anong sagot dito? For I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me drink. I was a stranger and you welcomed me. I was naked and you clothed me. I was sick and you visited me. I was in prison and you came to me. Yung mga yellow words dito are helping behaviors. That's the reason why they were placed on his right. They will be given heavenly rewards. Pero yung mga tao dito nagtaka. Huh? Eh di ba Diyos ka? Kailan ka namin nakita na in need? Eh ang Diyos is never in need. Ano ang sagot doon? Yun ay binasa natin sa opening verse a while ago before I started this lecture. And the king will answer them, truly I say to you, as you did it to one of the least of this, you did it for me. Yung mga tulong na ginawa nyo sa ibang tao, para nyo na rin ginawa sa akin. Therefore, you will be blessed. Welcome to the kingdom of heaven and receive your rewards. Got that? So that's our short lecture on the social psychology of helping. Sana marami kayong natutunan. If you have any questions or comments, ilagay nyo lang dyan sa baba. Sir Howard here. Until the next lecture, God bless everyone. Bye-bye.